Welcome everyone to something that you never asked for, but well, we could say that Mr. Alan asked for it, and today we are going to explore how to fix your HDR in your awful SFM or beautiful SFM maps, depending on how good you are at map making or taking them from the workshop. First of all, you'd think that HDR is not a big issue, because when you re-enable lighting, everything fixes. Mr. Shock Trooper does not agree with your unfounded opinion. So let's get right into it, and we're gonna launch a map where we can put this little cute Shock Trooper into its natural habitat of Black Mesa Research Facility. Where do you go? I don't allow you to go. Come back here now. So we have isolated our map in the test chamber. Code HOS01AMRL, which is a Half-Life 1 map that was taken from the Garry's Mod workshop of a person who went through the extreme lengths of porting all those crazy maps. Props to you and your insanity of reaching such achievements on a global scale of the Half-Life community. And here, when we launch the map, we get the beautiful message telling us, you got slapped! What you gonna do about that, eh? We do not have HDR because this beautiful person who ported the maps knew full well that HDR was going to be a hassle he did not want to partake. Or it could be anything else. We click OK. And now we're in the test chamber, right? And this is the map. I just put Mr. Cute Trooper here. Alright. And we have the camera. Let's just save. And we save because we want to make a comparison. This is the map with HDR. So now, if we just re-enable lighting, this is how it looks like. And you'd be like, but Barkovas, it looks perfectly fine to me. What do you mean it looks perfectly fine? Everything is pale. Everything has lost its color. Everything is disgusting. Don't mind the missing things on the map. Just put out an entity. Oh, that's all. There could be missing stuff, that's not an issue. The issue here is the HDR. I'm not here to fix your missing textures. You can do that yourself. Alright, so how do we proceed? Save it, because we want to make comparison. After that, you want to search in Google Java JDK. You go to the Oracle website, and you are met with many options, which probably you don't need to click. And you can either install number 15, number 11, number 8. Try all of them if they don't work. Start from the top, go to the bottom. And whichever works, works best for you. I have number 14. I'm not sure where it is. It's gone. Then I want you to search for BSPsource. You'd be like, what is that? It's a tool you're going to use to achieve your dreams. You go in there and you figure out how to download, right? So you get BSPsource, and that's how you decompile the map which doesn't have HDR on. Alright, so now you've put your sweet BSPsource in a folder somewhere, alright? What you need to see is, you need this, bspsrc.jar. And that's what you need JavaScript for, otherwise it ain't gonna run. Boom! And now we have this little sweet window opening for us to be like, what am I supposed to do? So now, you grab the map that you want to decompile, and you slap it in there! Haha! Oh, don't click on it, it's dead. And now you have it, and you just click decompile. And it's going to ask you where, and you choose somewhere convenient, pretty much the same place, decompiled. It's decompiled. Wait, where is it? Oh, it decompiled somewhere else. So in my case, it decompiled here. I'll just slap it in here. And now we have this as a .vmf, which means Hammer, Source Hammer, will be able to understand the secret language. So we open Hammer, and we open, I just use a shortcut. Chat. Guys, I press Control O, you can do that as well. Stop trying to, you know me! And now you click on it. Now your map is gonna load, and everybody's gonna be happy until you realize, what am I supposed to do now? Oh my god! Now you are supposed to just compile. You can change stuff. I don't see textures here because they are the gold source is using some kind of strange renaming conversion, which breaks pretty much the Hammer preview. But Even if it looks like this, you can still delete stuff, not change the textures, and everything will be all right. I'm not here to teach you mapping. I'm here to teach you how to fix your HDR. So now you just run the map. How do you run F9? Instead of pressing it, just press F9. And now it's going to compile. You're going to have, don't run game after compiling, and wait for key press. That's useful. And by the way, I am using the SFM hammer. The SFM hammer is located inside. Where was it located? Where are you? Where is you? Where is my SFM? Your SFM hammer. Here, I'll just leave so you could easily figure out. You go to Steam, Steam Maps, Common, Source Filmmaker, Game, Bin, and then you just type hammer, and then you press enter. And now you're entering Nirvana, and you're like at the gates, but four saps you and says you don't want you, so you know you got to figure out life for yourself. The hammer is launching on the other screen. There, we have hammer here on this side. Control O, select map, wait for it. It's thinking, it's reading the chunks, it's reading your chungus. Where is the chungus? I need him now. Give him to me. And now we have it. So now we just press F9. We wait, you know, live. And we just click OK. And now on the other screen, there's a lot of errors for materials, for this and that. It doesn't matter, chat. It doesn't matter because this is about fixing the HDR. If you want to fix your materials, you want to fix your lights and leaks, then you do that. Of course, now, sometimes the map is not going to compile because there might be a leak, which means somewhere around the map, there is open geometry which is leaking into the void. This is a problem with Source 1. How you fix it? You have to find the leak, which is called a point file, and plug it in. I will show you the button, but I will not show you in practice how that looks, because if you click the button, then you will see a red line on your map and you just find where the red line goes to and you plug them up yourself. Here we have our map compiled and I'm just going to show you the point file, which is when you have a leak and thing crashes or doesn't have HDR working or the lights don't work, that means you have a leak. So you go to map and you click on load point file. And you will have in decompiled a lin or PTS file, which you will select. And then there is going to be a red arrow somewhere around the map, which you're going to use to navigate yourself in fixing your bloody map. And that's how you would fix your leak. Your HDR will work perfectly. If you have a leak, fix it, and then you will manage to compile properly. So we rendered it 100%. I'm sure it's going to work. Close the necessary stuff. And here now, I'm going to tell you something. SFM Hammer renders compiles maps in user mode, which means that you need to go to your user mod, which is located in Steam Maps Common SFM Game User Mod Maps. And here it is. Wait, this is an old one. Here it is. This is your decompiled map. This is your recompiled map with HDR on. You don't believe me? I'm going to launch it right now. So here we have the old map. So we unload it. Unload the maps and throw the hounds at evil people. Rescan. And here we have the D, you know, the decompiled. We click it, we wait. The Chuck Trooper is gonna be happy. Is he gonna be happy? He's gonna be incredibly happy to meet this incredible new world of lighting, colors, and atmosphere that Black Mesa has never been able to offer this little tiny Chuck Trooper. Of course, it has to load first, but the bigger question is if I'm recording all this. I really hope I'm recording it all properly. We're not getting an error for no HDR. Look. And then you'd be like, but Markovas, it looks even worse. Oh, calm down. Look at it. Look at it. It's beautiful. It's got colors, man. Look, look, look. Oh my God, I can now put my lights and everything will look beautiful. Everything will look the way it's supposed to look. Now just reduce the intensity. And now you have HDR on your map and your colors are working as they should. Are you happy with the outcome? Do you see how many things you have to do before you get to anywhere in this bloody SFM conundrum of problems, problems, and problems? It's up to you if you think this is worth your time to fix. But in my case, it took me 10 minutes. In your case, it might take you 100 minutes. But sooner or later, you're going to reach the 1 minute mark. Thank you, Mr. Allen, for suggesting this. I hope this helps you. And I, yeah, tune up for next live stream, people, because this is, this is SFM Toolbox. I am forgetting my Sea of Shock Trooper. Stop them! Stop them! Destroy all of these NPCs! Do not let them attack us!